Well, this is BBC Radio 3, time now for World Roots, and this week we'll hear highlights from a concert held last month at the Brighton Festival. The programme's introduced by Lucy Duran.
The Brighton Festival has been going for nearly 50 years now, and every year it's brought literary events and ballet, as well as concerts of all kinds, to the Brighton Dome and to other venues around this lively seaside town. Well, someone who's been going for rather longer than the festival is our main artist in this concert. He's 75, and he's been ranked by the Rolling Stone magazine as one of the 100 greatest artists of all time. He's Lee Scratch Perry, a Jamaican producer and musician who was a pioneer of reggae and who also started off the style known as dub. As well as giving concerts, Lee Perry is still recording. His brand new album, Rise Again, is out this month. He's joined in the concert by the British producer, Adrian Sherwood, who I'll be talking to later on, who helped to relaunch Perry's career in the 1980s, and also by the Jamaican veteran singer, Max Romeo. You may remember Max Romeo from a concert of his that we recorded on World Roots 2 years ago in Agadir in Morocco. And in fact, he more or less owes his career to Lee Perry, who co-wrote and produced most of his biggest hits. Well, just to give you an idea of what we're in for, in the next hour, the American musician Bill Laswell, who produced Lee Scratch Perry's new album, has described his music in these words: fusing eccentric spiritual vision with Rastafarian psychedelia, surreal experimental pop, powerful protest music, and solid dub reggae with African overtones. We'll hear Lee Scratch Perry doing a set of his own later on. First, from the Brighton Dome, here's Max Romeo.
Give Jah the praise, man. Yeah. A lot of silly things going on in the world today, but don't let it bother you. Just give Jah the praise. Send your praises up and your blessings will come down. Rastafari. They fed the mothers with sour grapes and set our teeth on edge. Hey. Stealing in the name of the Lord. Stealing in the name of the Lord. Stealing, stealing, stealing. Stealing, stealing. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. It's been a long time. I've been around these parts from 1969, yeah? And there's a wet dream days. A lot of you remember, eh? I'm still around, still doing it, still feeling good. All right. We'll be right back. Love the vibe.
That was Max Romeo playing Back to the Bible to a rapturous audience here at the Brighton Dome as part of the festival concert dedicated to roots reggae and dub, which also features Adrian Sherwood and later on the legend Lee Scratch Perry. So, Max, you and I met 2 years ago at the Agadir Festival,
yes,
at the Timitar Festival in Agadir,
yes,
in Morocco, and I remember you saying that that was your very first time on African soil.
Yeah, it was. It was.
And I hadn't realized when I met you in Agadir how closely connected your career has been to that of Lee Scratch Perry.
Well, I would say Lee Scratch Perry helped me along very much in my career with that album Warner Babylon that he produced with me. It was a great effort on his part. You know, he's always there when you put a song together. He's always there to correct you if it's wrong. He's a special breed of producers, and it was fun working with him all these years, you know.
So what makes him a special breed of producers?
He's a real producer. He helped you along with the song. You know, he knows notes, you know, chords, you know, timing, and he's a lyricist himself. So if you're using a word that's not compatible to what you're trying to say, he can always correct you so you can have the right thing. I go into the studio and say, "Why in a Babylon, it's rough out there, man, it's wicked out there." He said, "Look, it's a simple out there. It's a new word. It have a ring to it, and it means slippery. That means actually saying the same thing you are saying. So use simple instead of wicked out there." And I said, "Simple out there." That was great. very good. Very good producer.
So he's like an all-round producer, someone who's a musician as well as,
yes,
someone who knows how to create a sound.
Yeah, he's all around, you know. He doesn't play an instrument professionally, but he's a great percussionist. He make music out of anything, stone, bottle, don't matter. You know, you just find music in things. It's great.
I wonder whether you know that the theme of this festival, the Brighton Festival this year, is freedom of speech.
Oh, wow. If I'd known, I would say more on stage.
And obviously, message is a very important part of your music, isn't it, Max?
It is, yeah, it is. You know, I don't write just album, I write concept albums. And the message have to be strong before I, you know, finalize the whole thing. It have to be saying something, you know. It's not just off the top of your head. That's why I rarely sing "Darling, I Love You." You know, I sing about signs of the times, you know, and human living together and what have you, you know. I prefer to deal with that area, you know. Yeah.
So you think reggae still has that kind of very serious side to it, as well as just being great music to listen to dance to?
Reggae is a serious music. It's a medium that we as Rastas used to get our message across. That's one of the most important elements of the music. And what you'd call, it's a melting pot music. It's been done by all races. It's not a particular black music or white music. It's just music that everybody loves and enjoys. That's the great thing about reggae, and that's why it's been around for so long and will always be around.
It's simple out there. Are we ready now? War in a Babylon, Trident. Let me hear you, Brighton. It's simple out there. Yeah. Who are you saying? shame. A man's pride shall bring him low, yeah. So low. Hannah shall uphold the humble in spirit. And we know it's true, yeah. Oh, yeah. War in a bar. Tribal war in a bar. Who will you say? You sit with all day. Oh, yeah. No. You sit with all day. Thank you.
That was Max Romeo from Jamaica with the band The New Upsetters, performing here at the Brighton Dome as part of the Brighton Festival 2011. A special evening devoted to roots reggae and dub. And later on in the programme, we're going to be treated to Jamaica's legendary artist, Lee Scratch Perry. But I'm now with the UK producer, Adrian Sherwood, who's been very much a part of reviving the career of Lee Scratch Perry. And you're going to be performing with him as well.
I'm not actually performing with him. What I'm doing tonight, I'll be doing live sound for him, where I'm almost like an extra member of the band. The band will be playing, and they'll have effects going, but I'll be acting my part as almost like the sound engineer in a studio, creating a studio atmosphere in the venue. I'll be adding reverbs, delays, phasers, sound effects, noise machines over the top of the band, which is basically dub mixing.
Because, I mean, that's really an important part of the Jamaican music sound, isn't it?
With dub, that is the preserve of the engineer. The musicians have all played. The dub engineer strips down the music and does an interpretation where he acts as the extra musician playing with the sound. And that is unique to Jamaican music.
So the producer is really, as you said, it's really another musician.
Well, with the Jamaican music, people have their own sound. And the thing that separates Lee from everybody else is Lee has a very identifiable sound, even before the Black Ark. Then at the Black Ark, his famous studio that he burnt down, he had the sound using certain bits of equipment, some of which I'll be using tonight, like a Mutron biphase, Space Echo, Echoplex, you know, different machines he had. We'll be using some of those machines tonight. So I'll be acting in the role of the person adding the spice and nicing up the sound as a dub mixer tonight.
And that sound goes back to, what, the late 60s, early 70s?
Really early 70s it started developing with Lee Perry. You know, back in the 60s they were playing with reverbs, you know, with Larry Marshall. He's credited as inventing reggae because of the cha-cha on the guitar. All this is debatable, but that's possibly the origins of it, when they bought an amp and it had the delay on it, and they hit a jing, and it went jing-jing, and that's how they got the cha-cha on reggae. And then Lee pushed the boundaries, as did Lee, Augustus Pablo, Keith Hudson, King Tubby, Errol T, because all of those were engineers as well. So a producer is slightly different to an engineer, but they were engineer producers. And you've got the history of...
And that's what you are. Are you
that's what I am as well. I've modelled myself on my heroes, yes.
So, I mean, the term dub, can you define it for us?
Well, the word dub comes from, if you overdub something, you add something to it. You know, if you're overdubbing a guitar...
After you've recorded the original session, you overdub something.
That's overdubbing. But then dub mixing is where... What the word, the most important word that is not really used anything like as much, dub is overused almost, version is the key. In Jamaican music, they love a rhythm. If they love a rhythm, they version it maybe 30, 40, 50 times, the same rhythm. But different vocalists, different DJs, different instrumentations, and people love it. They love version. Beyonce, if she has a great rhythm, you only hear the one version. If the Jamaicans were given the tape, they would strip it down, they would put six singers, six DJs on the same thing, and people would buy it. They might not buy it as much as the original, but in some cases, people have bought the version has become a hit, like Althea and Donna's Uptown Top Ranking. That was another song years before it was a hit for them. It was a song called I'm Still In Love With You.
So if you've got a great song, keep it alive.
And dub version is simply the instrumental stripped down version of one of these songs, because all good dubs come from a song originally. They take the vocalist off, they take most of the instrumentation off, and they rip it to pieces with delay and a very minimalist use of the instruments. So you might just have the bass drum, the drums, and maybe bits of guitar jumping in and out, and bits of just parts of the vocal. That's dub. And if you look at dubstep now, it's the stripped down bare bones of a really vibey B-line acting with a drum thing and a groove that makes the contemporary modern... what you're calling dubstep or even jungle. And that all comes from the history and legacy of the Jamaican production houses of the 70s.
And Lee Scratch Perry.
Lee Scratch Perry is one of the most important people of 20th century music.
And so how can you say that? Why is Lee Perry so important?
If you look at how he's inspired people, how the use of the effects is in every modern record, you look at like a Britney Spears record, they've all got this supersonic, this delay. lots of records that have the mischief and the character in them. A lot of the hip-hop crowd, the KRS-One to whatever, all had Jamaican parentage. And Lee was the prime mover in creativity. His influence on Bob Marley. Bob Marley sings like Lee Perry. Lee's not a great singer, but Bob Marley lived on Lee Perry's couch for 2 years when he came back from working in the car plant in America. And Lee took him under his wing, and the influence on his career with opening the minds to black awareness, to the developing Rasta movement, Lee was instrumental in that. Also his work with all the pioneers like Junior Biles, going through to his experimental dub productions, and the standard he set and where he put people's heads, that has spread like Maluka honey, whatever it's called, everywhere, the best honey, the best vibe. And that's what I think of Lee. I'm not saying that like kissing his backside or anything. He is majorly important.
Okay. He has been around from the mid-40s. And now it is in the year of 2011, and he's still going strong at the age of 75, would you believe? From the Blackhawks and of Kingston, Jamaica, the legendary Lee Scratch Perez!
Hi, how you gonna chase down Rihanna? Chase down Rihanna, chase down all the time. We gonna chase down, we gonna chase down, we gonna chase down all the time. Jump into the cabin, and then I'll plug to the car. If my father was a for us, you lock a lump in with a scar. Building churches and penitentiary, every day you spin another yard. We gonna chase those crazy warheads. Chase those crazy warheads. Chase those crazy warheads out of town. One side, we gonna chase those crazy president. Chase those crazy president. Chase those crazy president out of town. Put it together, then. Scooby-dee-dooby-dooby-dooby. How do you do? You're my lovey-lovey. I needed you. You need I need you. Together, booty, and it too. Put your hand together. Put your hand together. Put your hand together. We're gonna chase those crazy bumpheads. Chase those crazy bumpheads. Chase those crazy bumpheads all the time. We're gonna chase those crazy dictators. Those crazy dictators. Those crazy Freemasons all the time. Chasing Freemasons. Chase them, chase those Illuminati. Chase, chase them. We gonna crush their party. Illuminati, we gonna crush your party. Illuminati, we gonna crush your party. Illuminati, we gonna crush your party. Everywhere, crazy politician. Scooby-Dooby. How do you do? You are my chosen. You are my chosen. We're gonna skip, 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 skip. Jump. I said a jump, jump, jump. I said a jump. I wanna see you jump, jump and jump. It's a crazy politician. Just a crazy politician. Just a crazy Freemason. Chase those crazy Freemason. They're gonna chase them. Chase them. Boom them. Pull them. Kick them. Kick them. Out of there. Crazy politician. Hello, Bob Marley. Hello, Bob Marley fans. Hello. Hello, Bob Marley fans. Wave and say to Bob, come out of your grave and wave, wave. For this is a brand new wave. Another wave, another wave, another wave. Another wave, another wave, another wave. We gonna dog. We gonna rub and rub and rub and scrub. And love and love and love and love. Put your hands in the air. I say to you, Papa, I love you. I love you.
Yeah, it is. I am asking you out there to give I a light while I bless your sight and put you on another night to have another dream in the land of the fairies, in the land of the peri, Jalev.
Yeah.
cut your hair and make a dog. Clap to the drum, clap to the drum. Hang on your tongue, stick out your tongue. You clap with the drum and then you gonna drum.
Lee Scratch Perry performing here at the Brighton Dome as part of the 2011 Brighton Festival. And I'm backstage with the man himself now. Great pleasure to meet you, Mr. Perry. I have to tell you, listeners, that he is, as we speak, putting a large magnified mirror around his neck on a thick gold chain. And he's got an enormous ring on every finger. And his hair is bright red.
Yeah.
And you look terrific. You look sensational.
Well, I'm the future king at the powerful BBC. The only thing that is missing, well, from the BBC is I. So now ABC, ABBC are together. I am A, alien from outer space. Meet BBC. Again, we always meet BBC and BBC and me, Lee Scratch Perry, is very great. I don't see any greater team than Lee Scratch Perry and BBC. We are greater than MTV. We make MTV look small. But we ain't Lee Scratch Perry and BBC. Always there before Bob Marley was even here, ain't it?
Now, Mr. Perry, yes, speaking of Bob Marley, I mean, you've played such an important role in Jamaican music for a long time, for what, 40 years?
Yeah.
So what was it like with Bob Marley?
Well, he hear me. I was on top all the time with BBC. You were doing ska music, and I was doing something different with, like, on top of the pops with BBC.
And well, back in the 1960s?
On top of the pops. And I was doing even...
Was that before reggae? Did you really... Did you create reggae?
Ska music was finished, and the rocksteady music was finished. Then Bob would go away and go America and go to London and come everywhere until he trained me, come back to England and say he wanted to work with me. But he didn't have anything much. He was just singing some of James Brown's song, "My Cup is Overflow, and I Don't Know What to Do." I think that was a confession. So I told myself, so if his cup is overflowing and I don't know what to do, I think he need help.
So you started composing for him.
He always sing with his eyes closed, and the first miracle I ever see, he opened his eyes and read his songs and make one cut.
Well, and he did in one cut, in one take.
One take. Then I discovered that this guy have talent because I always close his eyes singing. And now he opened his eyes and take one cut. Then he have talent, he's a good reader also. And I said, he asked me to help him, and then I really help him, and after then I write Dopey Conqueror for him. And take him into a different level out of this ska music.
So you've been with reggae the whole time since it began? And how's it doing now? Do you think reggae is doing as well as it was doing when it was at its height at the time of Bob Marley?
No, reggae not doing well enough, you know, because no reggae is... The type of reggae I make is spiritual reggae. So the music they're doing now is not spiritual. So that's what is missing. It's missing the spirit.
Why? What's happened? Where is the spirit gone?
Well, the spirit is the God, you know. So the God, the spirit, speaks through the human being. And the human being thinks is him speaking. But while you are speaking in righteousness, it's God speaking. And if you're not speaking righteousness, then it's the devil speaking. So now the spirit is afraid of some of these singers because they don't have them smoke too much cigarette, smoke too much weed, marijuana, eat too much dead meat. So the spirit is hiding.
But your music is full of spirit.
Definitely. And God is a spirit, and God is righteous, and God is holy, and God is clean. But if your temple is not good enough for the God, he's not going to come inside. If you are full of dead meats and full of nicotine.
So, Mr. Perry, is this what keeps you going so strong? I mean, I gather you're 75.
Yeah.
You look in fine form, and you're obviously in fine voice, and, you know, you've got a crowd out there who are crazy for you.
Yes.
So what keeps you going?
The spirit. I'll show you a sample of the spirit.
He's picking up a bottle of water. And now he's pouring some water on his head and looking very happy doing so.
Yes. You spirit?
Yeah, of course.
You like me to baptize you?
Are you going to baptize me?
Yes, no, okay. I'm going to baptize you.
This is Lee Scratch Perry who's going to baptize me.
God the Father,
pouring
God the Son,
water.
God the Holy Spirit. You are baptized.
Well, that's something. That's an experience.
Then you'll be
and now it's on my shoes.
Yeah, you'll be getting so
shoes.
Good lucky that you wonder what happened. It's a miracle.
I'm happy. And so looking forward
Enjoy
to hearing life. More music from you,
well,
Lee Scratch Perry.
I am trying to be a man, but I'm an angel.
Yeah. the children dance. Let the people dance. Let the children dance. Let the people dance on the streets again. Let the BBC. Let the BBC. Let the BBC.
Falling in, falling in.
love you.
Lee Scratch Perry performing at the Brighton Dome as part of the Brighton Festival 2011. He was joined by the new Upsetters. They're Derek Litchmore on sax, Barbara Snow on trumpet, Audrey Donegan on backing vocals, Diana White on bass, Mark Jordan on guitar, Caroline Williams on keyboards, and Noel Tapper on bass. On the mixer was Adrian Sherwood, and earlier on we heard Max Romeo. So here's one final number from the extraordinary Lee Scratch Perry.
Jungle Safari, Jungle Safari.
with Jungle Safari, sung by Lee Scratch Perry in a concert recorded last month at the Brighton Dome as part of the 2011 Brighton Festival. World Roots was presented by Lucy Duran and the producer was Roger Short.